Well, I gotta start getting these garden beds ready. So I'm gonna take the dirt out of the old location from last year and repurpose most of that. Getting up third here to fill up the planter boxes. Probably gonna finish this up in a couple of days. Well, like I said yesterday, this is gonna be a couple of day project. So today, basically what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take everything I've collected out of the chicken coop for the past couple of months, and I'm just gonna spread that out here where I was scraping yesterday. From there, I'm probably gonna let the chickens just kind of go through everything over the next couple of days. They're gonna pick through, try to find different food, different things like that. Probably Saturday morning, I'll come out and I'll re-scrape everything back up into piles, and then I'll be able to scoop that and take that over and put it directly into the planter boxes as our soil for the year. I think this plan should work pretty good. We definitely got a lot of chicken droppings in there that we've collected all winter, and it should just add that much more nutrients to the soil. Hopefully it's not too hot. Something that just happened. I thought it was pretty funny. It wasn't really supposed to be part of this video, but I just thought I'd talk about it. You know, stuff breaks around here. It breaks all the time, and sometimes you got to figure out how you're going to fix it. You know, I had a part break here on the lawn mower. I was putting the mower deck back on, and you know, for me to stop what I'm doing, go to the store, you know, order a part, maybe they have the part, I don't know. I mean, you could be talking hour. You know, it's gonna take me a half hour just to get to the John Deere store from here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna improvise and we're gonna fix this part. Well, it might not be the prettiest bolt in the whole world. Got it fixed in a couple of minutes. Might not be perfect. I don't think John Deere's hiring me anytime soon to come in and weld their bolts, but we're back fixed. Well, today I'm gonna do a couple of things out here. Right where the new greenhouse is gonna go and right where the planter box garden is gonna go is this old fire pit. So we're gonna get rid of that. I burnt it down the other day, and now I wanna remove all that decorative block out of there and get rid of that. So I'm gonna work on that tonight. And then tomorrow morning, I'm gonna come in and I'm gonna start scraping all of that black dirt up for them planter boxes. The chickens went through that area this week pretty heavily, mixed it all around, made some more compost for us. So I'm gonna go through that area, and we'll start filling these planter boxes in the morning, but we're gonna get this mess cleaned up right here for now. Well, it's Saturday, it's gorgeous outside, and we're gonna get it done today. The area should be ready to go. I'm gonna go in here and just scrape this out a little bit. And then I went out and I put the planter boxes where they're gonna go. I did that last night, went and set them down. They need to get leveled and kind of shoved around just a little bit, but they're pretty much ready to be filled up. So we're gonna get going. It's a beautiful day. Hey, good morning, Deuce. You hungry? Should we get you some food? All right, we'll get some food. Morning, little chickens. You guys want some water? Oh, you got water. All right. Get big so you can go play outside. figured I'd take a second to talk about this back bucket that I have, in case anybody sees it in the video and says, what the heck is that? It's actually originally a Dearborn back scoop that I converted. There was a really good deal on it. Somebody wanted $20 for it. I couldn't pass it up. I was looking at it and thought, man, if you could turn this thing around, that'd be pretty slick. I thought, I can't pass that up. You can't even buy half the steel for $20. So I ended up, I picked it up and I did some modifications to it and converted it. It works pretty good. One negative is, in order to dump, I do have to get off the tractor versus the Dearborn scoop that I have, but it works pretty darn good for backing into piles of stuff and getting it picked up. I'll probably do a longer video later on about how I converted it and that whole process, but for now I figured I'd just mention it in case anybody sees it and is trying to figure out what in the heck is he using on that thing. We got the morning chores all done. Ducks have water. Baby chickens have water. Everybody's happy. So I've started to work a little bit on these planter boxes before I get them filled up. What I ended up doing was I took a torch to the outside of them and put a little bit of like a char on them. I actually kind of like the way that they turned out. They have a little bit of a nice patina to them. I think they look pretty gorgeous. But that char on there should help them last a little bit longer. They were built out of heat-treated pallets, but this should just give them a little bit more longevity and hopefully we get a few years out of them. Well, things are going pretty good. Van came out to join me and help me finish this last part. We'll get the planter boxes completely full. They're ready to go. The soil looks pretty good. At least for me, one indicator of really good quality soil is how many worms you find in it. And I can tell you that these planter boxes are absolutely loaded with worms from what I can see. So just about every shovel full I'm seeing dozens. So they must like what's in it, that's for sure. One last step that I'm gonna do before we get planting, that'll probably happen tomorrow probably. I'm gonna add in a microbial solution that I made, and I'll plan on probably showing how that works in another video, but I wanted to at least have that be the last part of this one. So let's go add some JMS solution and get these things finished up. Well, that just about takes care of the planter boxes, so I appreciate everyone who watches these. Do me a favor, hit that subscribe button if you're not subscribing already. I really appreciate it, and also like the video. The last thing I was gonna share with you is today's pretty exciting. It's the first day that all the ducks get to be outside, so I'll end the video with that. Otherwise, until next time, thank you for watching.